But first, in the frantic horse trading that went on after last year's hung election, the independents demanded the NBN in the bush. If that guaranteed her the prime ministership, Julia Gillard would have probably promised to roll it out to the moon. Well, now, today in fact, the NBN is up and running on the mainland. Funnily enough, in independent MP Tony Windsor's New South Wales bush electorate. 6.30's Eddie Meyer today visited the university town of Armidale to see whether all the fuss has been worth it.
As regional centres go, Armidale ticks all the boxes, picturesque and peaceful. Its pace of life is best described as sleepy. In one aspect, though, that slow pace is about to change.
3, 2, 1.
With all the theatrics a Prime Minister can summon, the National Broadband Network came to Armidale and its 25,000 residents. But in reality, just 7 people here are actually using it, part of a trial to test its systems and processes. One of them is Saren Trump. She runs a communications business from home. To say she's enthusiastic doesn't come close to explaining her experience.
Usually I was rushing around town with a USB stick or a CD to drop off files to clients, whereas now I can email it. I know for my business there's things I can think about doing now that I never thought I could do before, like subcontract to people in different cities and things like that.
Armidale is a university town. Many students are external, relying on the vagaries of their internet speeds to connect. Byron Miles is also one of the trial participants. He now downloads in a minute what used to take an hour.
Like with the old connection, if I was downloading something or someone else was using it at the same time, then it was generally pretty slow and you couldn't do much else with it. Whereas now, you know, you can be downloading something, watching YouTube, chatting to friends, doing uni work all at the same time.
Just 7 may be in the trial, but 3,000 homes and businesses have had the fibre roll to their doorsteps and will connect over the next few months. People are generally positive.
What's your service like now?
Oh, pretty average. Yeah, we live out of town and don't get very good coverage.
It's used for that many things now, like it should. You should be able to get good coverage because it's such a big part of everything.
If they were to put it down my street, I'm not sure that I would connect to it because I'm quite happy with the service I've got at the moment. But university is obviously a very sensible investment, I would have thought.
4 other cities are also being connected elsewhere in New South Wales, in Queensland, Victoria and South Australia. Tony Windsor, the local federal member, fought for Armidale to be among the first recipients of the National Broadband Network. He believes criticisms are due to a city-country divide. Here, he says, people just get how important it is.
It has the capacity to actually reverse the paradigm that country Australians have lived in for many decades, that one of distance and remoteness.
Cost has been a key criticism of the NBN project since it was very first announced, not just of building it, but what it might cost users to actually plug in. Now, from the Prime Minister, Communications Minister and NBN Chief today, assurances it simply will not cost any more to use the National Broadband Network.
But then for the enthusiastic few plugged into this brave new world of internet speed, some things can't be measured in cost alone.
I think the benefits far outweigh the cost. When we're talking about making regional and rural businesses in Australia competitive internationally, it could be any cost.
Music, no doubt, to the Prime Minister's ears, just when she might need it most.